We want to determine dy dx and then determine the slope of the tangent line at the point 2, 2. Notice our equation is an implicit equation because it's not solved for y. So we'll determine dy dx using implicit differentiation. So we'll take the derivative of both sides with respect to x. So while we're setting this up, let's go ahead and distribute x squared as well. So we'll have x to the fourth. This will be plus x squared times y squared equals the derivative of 8y squared with respects to x. So the derivative of x to the fourth with respects to x would be 4x cubed. But now when we determine the derivative of x squared times y squared, we're going to have to apply the product rule. So we'll have the first function, which is x squared, times the derivative of y squared. And since this term involves y, we'll have to apply the chain rule. So we'll have an extra factor of dy dx. So the derivative of y squared with respect to x would be 2y times dy dx plus the second function, which is y squared, times the derivative of the first function, which would be the derivative of x squared, which is 2x, equals the derivative of 8y squared with respect to x would be 16y times dy dx. Again, the term involves y, therefore we have to apply the chain rule, so we have an extra factor of dy dx. So now we have to solve this for dy dx, so the rest is going to be algebra. What's a little bit different about this example is we have two terms that involve dy dx, this term here and this term here. So we do have to get these on the same side. So we'll move this product to the right side of the equation. So we'll have 4x cubed plus 2xy squared. It's going to equal 16y dy dx minus 2x squared y dy dx. Now we still need to solve this equation for dy dx. So what we're going to do here is factor out dy dx from these two terms. So we'll have dy dx times the quantity 16y minus 2x squared y. And now because these are attached by multiplication, we can divide both sides by the quantity 16y minus 2x squared y to solve for dy dx. This simplifies to 1. So we have dy dx is equal to this quotient, but notice how there is a common factor of 2 between the numerator and denominator. So in factored form, we would have 2 times the quantity 2x cubed plus xy squared all over 2 times the quantity 8y minus x squared y. So this 2 simplifies out, and the final form of our derivative would be dy dx equals 2x cubed plus xy squared divided by the quantity 8y minus x squared y. And this does not simplify any further. So this is the first part to this question. But now we want to evaluate this at the point 2, 2. So we'll substitute 2 for x and 2 for y. So 2 cubed would be 8, 8 times 2 would be 16, plus 2 times 2 squared, that's going to be 8. Our denominator is going to be 8 times 2, that's 16. And this will be 2 squared times 2, so we'll have minus 8. So our numerator is going to be 24. Denominator is going to be 8, so our derivative is equal to 3 at the point 2, 2. So this tells us the slope of the tangent line at the point 2, 2 of the given graph would be 3. Let's check that graphically. So here's the graph of our equation in black, and the tangent line at the point 2, 2 is graphed in blue. Notice this tangent line has a y-intercept of negative 4, which means the equation of the tangent line would be y equals 3x minus 4. Let's go ahead and check the slope between these two points. The rise would be from negative 4 to positive 2, that's up 6. And the run would be 2 units to the right, or positive 2. And the slope of 6 over 2 does simplify to 3. So this does verify our work on the previous slide. I hope you found this helpful.